In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Welcome back to your program, Approaches. And tonight we are going to speak about the holy zeal in service. Let's read some passage from the words of St. Paul. For you yourselves know, brethren, these are written in his letter to Thessalonians, the first letter to Thessalonians. He was saying, for you yourselves know, brethren, that our coming to you was not in vain, but even after we had suffered before and were spitefully treated at Philippi, and no, we were bold in our God to speak to you the gospel of God in much conflict. For our exhortation did not come from error or uncleanness, nor was it in deceit, but as we have been approved by God to be entrusted with the gospel, even so we speak, not as pleasing men, but God who tests our hearts. Let's start following this passage again. He started saying, for you yourselves know, brethren, that our coming to you was not in vain. So in our meditation tonight, let's review this, that is our service always productive? His service was not in vain. So in order to make your service fruitful, you need to start your service with prayer. We can never, as we had said before many times, we can never approach others or help others to see the truth and to know Christ without the power of prayer. So St. Paul with the disciples could change the whole world with the word of God because they were men of prayer. And also they had zeal in their heart. Their heart was full of zeal, the holy zeal. They love people. And they loved their salvation, and they were doing their best to save as many as they can. So by this deal, they always produce fruits. Also, you know, as he said in this passage, their hearts were full of fear of God. In their service, they always think of Christ looking at them and following them up in their service. With this fear of God in the heart, their service was never in vain. Another important item, so your service will never be in vain, that you need to be a repentant service. The heart of a repentant service, this heart is full of fire of the Spirit, because repentance is the key of kindling the fire of the Spirit inside your heart. So when you repent and you enjoy going back always to the truth, to the embrace of Christ, you are always productive. Also, in order to have a fruitful service, you need to be a good disciple to the Word of God and also to the church traditions, to the church fathers. Then St. Paul said, even after we had suffered before and were spitefully treated at Philippi, as you know, we were bold in our God to speak to you the gospel of God in much conflict. So being bold in God to speak the gospel of God, you know, despite of pain, despite of injustice and persecution and failures, still they are bold in preaching and giving the word of God. So in order to approach others and affect them with the word of God, please do your best and overcome the negatives you face, whether failures, conflicts, pains, persecution. You have to be strong enough in order to continue your missionary and be bold in preaching the word of God. Then he said, in much conflict. In much conflict, this means that the service is never easy. We have to favor labor. We have to choose to be tired for the word, for the word of God. Because you know, if you relax, if you enjoy sleeping, you will never be productive in your service. You know, this kind of conflict or much conflict, meaning that you prepare the word of God, you pray much for the word of God, you also live the word of God so people can see the living word of God in your life. Another word given by St. Paul in this passage, for our exhortation did not come from error or uncleanness, nor was it in deceit. So his word was the word of God, and you know there was kind of commitment to the teaching of the church. Our exhortation did not come from error or uncleanness. The error usually stands for the deviations from the Orthodox Christian belief. And all through history, you know, we faced many deviations and heresies. But being honest, you have to proclaim the word of God in an honest way and being committed to the Orthodox faith. Also, he said, uncleanness, nor was it in deceit. So we need to be committed to the purity of the teaching and the method of teaching. We are not only pure in the content of the sermon, but also in the way we present the word of God. It should be clean. It should be respectful, because we are telling the people the truth, the word of God. Another kind of commitment in this passage, that we have to be committed to the purity of the purpose by saying nor in deceit. He was never deceitful. He was honest in his purpose. He never looked after his glory, his pride. He never think of being famous. He was always busy with the salvation of the souls. So the commitment to the pure goal, which is the kingdom of heaven to everyone. So by saying our exhortation did not come from error or uncleanness, nor was it in deceit, meaning that we have to be committed to the teaching of the Orthodox Church and the purity of the method and teaching, and also the purity of the purpose. Finally, St. Paul was saying in this passage, but as we have been approved by God to be entrusted with the gospel, even so we speak, not as pleading men, but God who tests our heart. So by saying so, you know, God examining our heart, testing our heart. So in approaching others, we always need to look inside our heart to see clearly whether we aim at their salvation, at the will of God, or other purposes. Like saying here, not pleasing men. Sometimes we just aim at pleading people. And if we are going to please others, usually we will never give them the truth, because some of the words of God are harsh, are tough, because the word of God may face people with their lusts and evil life. So by pleasing God only, we need to be honest in delivering the exact word and meaning of the Bible. So in this, you know, remind yourself that God is always examining our heart to see whether we love him in a pure way, and we want to deliver the message the right way he meant. Glory to God. Amen.